Alright. Thank you for joining me, fellow Guardians. This is Sam from Multiverse Mission Control, and today's quest is Kingdom Hearts. I went ahead and got the 1.5 plus 2.5 remix, and awkward title aside, it's got basically every Kingdom Hearts to date, minus Dream Drop Distance, and the stuff in 2.8 Final Prologue. Like, why do they keep making these weird mini installments when everyone wants the third game? Okay, but anyway. So, Kingdom Hearts 3 is on the horizon. It's basically gonna come out any day now. So I figure, like Shadow of Mordor and To the Moon, might as well get a jump on the series and bring it back to light quick, I guess. So, I just want to say, it's like... that music is taking me back right now. It's so funny, because nostalgia was one of the big selling points of this game, and now this is the nostalgia trip. But I do look back on some of the writing, and it's a little yuck at points, but and needlessly complicated on others, but I think that for the game's initial intended audience with first game, like for early teenagers, I think this game is freaking ideal. Because you're at that age where you're not quite a kid, but you're too young to be an adult. Everything is a transition, and even familiar things can start to seem dark and scary. You want to feel empowered, but also that it's okay to allow yourself to feel like a kid sometimes. You're getting saddled with new responsibilities and get told to think about your future, and part of you is just going like, is it still okay to like SpongeBob? Answer is yes. You like what you like, don't let other people tear you out of it, even when you're an adult. Anyway, I feel like this game captures the feeling of being lost and confused pretty well when the adventure starts in earnest. Then you feel on top of things for a bit, and then you get ripped right back out of it. Anyway, also, I'm not sure how I'm gonna do this, because a lot of these are prequels and companion stories. I think it's only right to start with the one that kicked it all off. I'll let you know what I decide with the rest. Even the little menu sounds are nice. This is just a nice game. And you gotta appreciate the nice games, because this is such a... this is a medium so saturated with the dark and gritty stuff. You just gotta appreciate the nice things when they come along. It's a shame Tarzan never made a return appearance. I liked him. I liked that movie. Okay. Ew. I'm not sure. I am a veteran. But I also feel like I'm gonna get my teeth kicked in. Nah, you know what? I haven't faced the final mix bosses on normal mode yet. They'll definitely... And you know what? For the purposes of a Let's Play, it's important I just be able to truck on through, so, you know. Oh boy. I think I'll go manual. Okay. At least I think that's how I did it. God, it's been so long. I'm old. And this intro, though.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
Good question to periodically ask. Remind me, wasn't this Haley Joel Osment? Who'd played Sora initially? okay, I was headbanging during that whole intro. I think my love for this game has not dulled. So much to do. So little time. Take your time. Don't be afraid. Do we ever figure out who you are? The door is still shut. Now step forward. Can you do it? Oh my god. Is it just me or did the graphics get way prettier? Also, are your feet indeed that incredibly large, or have you just mastered the art of loose-fitting footwear? I know why they did it. It's meant to, like, kind of hail back to Mickey Mouse. It's still kind of funny. Power sleeps within you. If you give it form, it will give you strength. Choose well. I forget what the ideal combination is here, especially for my playstyle. On principle, I kind of want to go with the knowledge power, but it actually kind of sucks. And on principle, I kind of want to go with the guardian power, because, hey, how do I begin the channel every time? The power of the guardian. Kindness to aid friends, a shield to repel all. Is this the power you seek? Absolutely. Consequences be damned. Your path is set. Now what will you give up in exchange? I wish magic were better. I mean, I will use it frequently. It's just, the stats are not enough. The power of the mystic, inner strength, the staff of wonder and ruin. You give up this power? Especially the ruin part, yes. You've chosen the power of the guardian. You've given up the power of the mystic. Is this the form you chose? Yes. Real life, my gut instinct is to give up the warrior power, but that's just not how it works. Is any of this for real? Or not? And we never get a clear answer. You've gained the power to fight. Oh, hold on. No. Whoa! Touchpad is to zoom in. That's also not what I want. Whatever. Let's just move on. It's just that I'm remembering. Alright, you've got it. That I used to move the camera with L1 and R1. Use this power to protect yourself and others. The green gauge displays your hit points. If you run out of hit points, you'll be taken to the continue screen. The blue gauge shows your magic points. Magic is still a mystery to you. Give it time. There will be times you have to fight. Keep your light burning strong. Alright. How do I target? R1. Right. And then it'll just pivot around the enemy for you. Very nice. And then how do you switch? Right. L2. But I think the switching is a little bit capricious. Oh well. Here goes. You gain experience by defeating enemies. With enough experience, you gain a level. Love 2 is an anagram. No. Oh, okay. Furthermore, defeated enemies sometimes leave items behind. You can take these items by walking up to them. Different items can do different things, like restore HP or MP. Behind you. Generally, you'll automatically target the nearest enemy, but you can lock onto a specific target by pressing R1. Lock on will appear in the upper left corner of the screen while you're locked onto a target. Locking onto a target limits the actions available to you, especially against other targets, but it does help you focus down a dude. Press R1 again to release a target block. There we go. God, I hate dreams like that. Just get sucked in and you can't breathe. This is a field icon. It pops up whenever a special command is available. When Triangle Examine pops up, you can press Triangle to examine the object in front of you. I can't open it. Chest. Always good. Unless it's a mimic. The triangle in the command menu turns into various commands. Open. You can push large crates. Push. Sometimes destroying objects yields items. You can take these items by walking up to them. You can lock onto objects as well as enemies. While locked on, press L2 to switch your focus between available targets. Right, and then you shift to the menu with the D-pad. And that can be tricky to do during combat, but you get the hang of it with repetition. But there's supposed to be a quick select menu. I'll have to remember how to use that eventually. Bust barrels, achieve enlightenment. Hold on, the door won't open just yet. First, tell me more about yourself. What's most important to you? You know, it's ironic that friendship actually gives you the worst kind of stats here, because I feel like... Then again, maybe you're supposed to answer as Sora. And right now, he is kind of about being number one. Is being number one such a big deal? Yeah. Maybe it seems disingenuous to pick the object that, like... The option that, everyone expects you to pick, or something, I don't know. What do you want out of life? To broaden my horizons. To broaden your horizons, huh? What are you so afraid of? Getting old, being different, being indecisive. That one. Being indecisive? Is that really so scary? You want to be number one, you want to broaden your horizons, you're afraid of being indecisive. Am I supposed to hit X? I am. Okay. Your adventure begins at midday. Keep a steady pace and you'll come through fine. No. That's not it. Okay, tell me again about the real you. I want the one that begins at dawn. See, this actually affects how fast your party members level up. And I don't want to be dragging around no... Should I look this up? I'll get it right eventually. You want to be number one. You want to see rare sights. You're afraid of getting old. Why are you stuck on that one? Your adventure begins at dawn. As long as the sun is shining, your journey should be a pleasant one. Sounds good. Although, now my character sounds like an asshole. The day you will open the door is both far off and very near. Well, I suppose it's very near for Sora, but it could take me, the player, a while to find the time, level up proper. Main menu, you can do things like etc. Right. Second verse. Look. Yeah, I'll take on the whole group. Why not? Looks like I'm getting back into the rhythm, okay? Health orbs. This is a save point. Touch save points to recover HP and MP. Press triangle to open the save menu. Be sure to save your progress before quitting the game. It's a good idea to save often. If anything goes wrong, you can then load your save data and resume from there. Very good advice indeed. Stained glass staircase. Yeah. It's like, should I go up there? Is that even gonna hold me? Alright. Here goes. The closer you get to light, the greater your shadow becomes. Wah! Dear God! But don't be afraid. And don't forget. A big old hole where its heart should be. Anyone else think this fight was vaguely reminiscent of Chernabog from Fantasia? And then he actually appeared in the game. Alright. So. I'm gonna get a lot more XP if I get to hit his head. So. He makes a little portal of darkness so that the Heartless come out. And I take this opportunity to stop. No. Darn it. I guess I'm not back yet. That's alright. Well, now I got you buggers to deal with. Good thing you give me healies. Well, he'll bend down eventually, right? Bash. Right. Yeah, no problem. Hey! Cheaty! Cheatsy doodle. Yeah, that's what I want. Just keep it there. Alright, time for redemption. This is gonna help me a bunch in the long run. There we go. Do it. Ah, not that. The other thing. Oh, I can hit him on his head. Oh, I forgot that was a thing. If my timing was better. There we go. Oh, hell yeah. Beat you with your own stuff. That is the most satisfying way to beat anything. And like anyone loses to the dark side, I felt pretty confident. But don't be afraid. You hold the mightiest weapon of all. Yeah, this fight doesn't seem like much now, but... so don't forget. But back when I was a kid and nightmares were frequent, this stuck with me. You are the one who will open the door. Because gosh darn, it's like someone just made a nightmare journal, took everything in it, and cobbled it together to make that thing. Especially when it, like, leans over you in the one attack that never showed up. Yeah. Hello!
Whoa!
Give me a break, Kyrie.
Sorry, you lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was
Every that time place? You wake up, you have to remember how reality bizarre. Works.
Yeah, sure.
Say, Kyrie, what was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
You ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
So what are we waiting for?
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you noticed. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh? What? Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
The days of youth. The world feels boundless, filled with opportunity. Alright. We got a raft to make on this idyllic island life. Or at least, that depends on who you ask. Anyway. So, can you gather the rest of the supplies? So, are you listening to me? Yeah, I heard you. Okay, here's what you need to go find. 2 logs, 1 cloth, 1 rope. Bring everything back here. If you need help, just ask. I'm counting on you. And I will do that, but I will also take a long time just kind of futzing about with the other stuff that I can do. Log. I'll just stick that in my pocket, carry it around. No big. So there's a save point in here. And the sea shy check. Yeah. And this also is a quick way to get up to the island. Although you can jump around to get up. Over there's Riku. And incidentally, does anyone else think it's weird that they named a character Riku when Enix already has a character named Riku? Who also ends up appearing in the series? Okay. Anyway. But Riku's a tough fight. Let's work our way up. And I have my wooden sword. Ja. And back here is the secret place. I don't think there's anything back here yet. That's still good to know. And there's this thing. I wonder where this door leads. And we never found out. I mean, I have a few guesses. Okay, so here we have the same characters we saw in our vision, only these are real people who share the islands with us. And they're all characters from Final Fantasy. Although, it's kind of weird, they're like alternate timeline versions. Titus certainly didn't grow up with Waka. Not until he time-traveled! But that's getting a... But that is neither here nor there.
Hey, what's happening, man?
Hey, Waka! So, each of these characters will help you get used to different enemy types. Titus is close range, Selfie's kind of mid, and then Waka here is long range. Yo, you up for a round? Sure, let's play. Play this for kids. This is serious.
Show me your stuff.
All right. So, you can't get close to this guy, or else he's gonna whack you one. So what you gotta do is reflect the balls back at him. This will help you get your timing down. Not to mention, it's good XP. I love how well this game is paced, because like,
oh, man. That really hurt.
You can spend forever on Destiny Islands just kind of honing your skills and getting used to the game's mechanics, and then basically when you get to the point where you feel like you can do these three at once with relative ease, then you're just like, okay, I'm ready to move on now. So.
The breeze feels great.
What are you up to these days? We never see you. Wanna duel? Way to dodge the question. Alright, now you're talking.
Okay, don't hold back. You ready?
Alright. I meant to hit the rope. Oh well. Sorry. Anyone else used to fight with sticks when they were kids? That was me in the woods. With my brothers. Then we would frequently go too far and hit each other in the eye. Oh well. This is video game world, so it never gets that bad. And who doesn't want the chance to kick the crap out of Titus?
Hey, Sora! You feel lucky today?
Why do you get to be cocky? I have never lost to you! Hey, Sora! Feeling up to a little competition? You asked for it! Alright, let's go! Yeah, sure. Ash. Okay, so my timing needs a little work to get back to where it was. Oh well. Still never lost to you.
Oh man, I'm really off today.
Today. Your entire existence is off. Your father's a time-traveling dream. Somewhere around here, there should be a chest. There's a cloth. Then I need another log, right? Did I need a box to get the chest? I think that's a secret path to the other half of the island, but we won't be able to go there right now. I guess the other log's up with Riku. Maybe the chest was on the other side of the island. It's been so long. Yeah, you know what? I'll do 1 3-on-1, and 1 with Riku, and then I'll call it an episode. Actually, I think I have to... Selfie thinks she's in charge around here. It's a drag. Okay. I think I have to talk to Titus to initiate it. Now I say when when you feel like you can handle 3-on-1 well, because, like, very few people get used to Riku when it's, you know, their first time playing. You three against me. Okay, you asked for it.
Let's get it. You ready?
That's right, come at me in a group. Whoops. Hey, I wasn't leaving, I was just...
Come on!
Like this!
Whoop!
You ready?
Selfie down.
Come on.
Okay. Titus down. And no offense, Waka, but you didn't really stack up before. Good. And then it makes that sound when you're in danger. Just keeps you aware of it the whole time. Nice little feature. There we go.
I can't believe we lost.
I can. Especially if you're leading. And doing 3-on-1 and battling Riku is a good way to get stocked up on potions early game. Although, you only have this first day to fight Riku, so the minute you go back over to Kairi, you lose that chance. Of course, if you thought the other three were tough, Riku basically mashes up everything in like a super unforgiving fight. He teaches you how to be very careful with how frequently you attack, to measure out your combat a bit. Did you get everything we need for the raft? I gave my stuff to Kairi. Hey Sora, how about a quick round? Grab your sword. Okay, you're on! This one decides the champion. You kicked my butt so many times when I was a kid. I'm a little scared. Ready or not? Okay, every four hits, he preps this counterattack thing. That! You gotta be careful. There's the log, I knew it! You've been hiding it! Whoop! That was my mistake. Here goes.
My turn.
There we go. That's the tough one.
Come on.
Sure. Here we go.
My turn.
Darn.
Come on.
Come on.
Oh, that was cheating. Oh, that too. You mixed up the rhythm. Whatever. I'll still beat you.
My turn.
Okay, I'm gonna stop doing that. There we go! Got too cocky. Almost lost. Now the score is 1-0! Yeah, sure! In this timeline! Okay, so that's day one of Destiny Islands in a nutshell. And you basically just gotta use this opportunity to hone your skills before you hit the main game in earnest. Because then it's gonna pull the gloves off. You're gonna be in a whole other world, alone, with no direction, with an infinitely spawning amount of enemies. So, I think I'm gonna use this opportunity to get myself some potions, because while there are many fights that you can technically lose without breaking up the story, I don't want to. I have my pride to think about, you know. So, thank you all for tuning in, Please comment and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. And remember, you all have the potential to get good. Peace out.